Rachel Garceau with your Idaho News 6 forecast.
You know, it's not going to cost you a lot is this forecast. Absolutely free to all of you who are watching, but you might want to just give it back by the time I'm all over and done with today, because we have what I like to call weather whiplash coming in this weekend. Today and tomorrow will really be pleasant. We'll get warmer today. We stay dry for about 90% of our Saturday, but then get ready by early Sunday. A cold, wet system rolls in. It will likely impact the entire day Sunday, especially because temperatures will plummet. Look at that number. Not a typo, by 20 to possibly up to 30 degrees from Saturday to Sunday across the region. You combine that with precipitation, there is the likelihood of some light snow falling above 6,500 feet. That is above most of our populated areas in the Central Mountains, but still, considering this is our last weekend of summer, kind of phenomenal that we are even talking about some snow. So yes, warmer today, very uneventful across most of the Northwest, but here is that leading edge of this system that we are anticipating 2 days from now. I know it doesn't look like it's 2 days away. It looks like it's pretty close, actually, right? This is a very slow-moving system, and that is kind of one of the problems here. It's going to be a soggy couple of days in the Pacific Northwest. Here's that fire hose of moisture, that plume right there, that will send warmer, wetter conditions to Seattle first. Colder air follows in behind, and we will have, again, those plummeting temperatures by Sunday. So rain temperatures, the biggest impacts for us in the Treasure Valley, even in the mountains, it will most likely be rain in most places. Wind will be a concern as well, and snow, again, just above those that 6,000 to 6,500 foot mark on Sunday morning and possibly Sunday night. So we'll have enough wind in advance of the system that we do have a red flag warning in effect for extreme fire conditions. We have low dry fuels, low humidities, gusty winds that will develop this afternoon and likely will stick around through tomorrow. Best and first chance of rain for the McCall area in particular looks to be dinner time on Saturday. We'll stay dry in the valley until this is about 3 to 4 o'clock in the morning Sunday. If you're a light sleeper, this is a heavy rain that will accompany this cold front, so that might wake you up. Then we'll just have scattered showers behind that soaking rain on Sunday, and temperatures will go from the mid-80s tomorrow to just the upper 50s in Boise on Sunday. Hard to believe all that's coming our way when this is our gorgeous Friday. 82 for Ontario, 84 for Nampa, Caldwell, Kuna, and Boise. 86 degrees in Mountain Home today. We were only in the low 70s in the Treasure Valley yesterday, so a nice warm-up coming in. We'll hit the 80s up in Garden Valley and Idaho City as well, flirting with 80 in Council. You'll get to about 79 today. Pleasant in McCall, Donnelly, and Cascade. Mountain temperatures don't budge a whole lot today. Still mid-70s from McCall over to Stanley and Sun Valley. Upper 70s in Fairfield. Little breezy in the Magic Valley today, but not like the gusty winds that will set in tomorrow across the region. Be ready for the wind if you're headed to the Boise State game tomorrow. It'll be dry and pleasant, but it will be windy, especially for you tailgaters going out early. 83 tomorrow, and then there's that big change up for Sunday. We'll top off at just 59 degrees. Crockpot cooking in order, I think, on Sunday. Forget the grill. Still cool on Monday. Then we do warm up as we head into the first day of autumn on Wednesday.